Good afternoon. It's Friday, February 24th, 2017. For All Western New York News and Radio, I'm Scott Leffler. Sunny today with a high near 68, showers overnight with steady temperatures. Then tomorrow, the temperature starts to fall to 36 by noon. Yuck. What's in the news? Congressman Brian Higgins joined over 150 members of Congress in a letter calling on federal law enforcement and justice agencies to swiftly address the circumstances leading to multiple bomb threats to Jewish community centers nationwide. This comes after a bomb threat forced the evacuation of the Jewish Community Center of Greater Buffalo's two Western New York locations earlier this week. There have been 68 reported incidents targeting 53 Jewish community centers in 26 states so far in 2017. Attorney General Eric Schneiderman and New York State Education Commissioner Mary Ellen Elia vehemently objected to the decision Wednesday by President Trump and the Federal Department of Education and Justice to rescind guidance that clarified federal legal protections for transgender students. The Attorney General and Commissioner reminded school districts across New York State that, irrespective of the federal government's decision, they have independent duties under state and local law to protect transgender students from discrimination and harassment in their schools and at all school functions. Police news. A 54-year-old Freedom woman was charged Thursday with driving while intoxicated following a traffic stop on Route 98. According to New York State Police, Susan R. Wilson was stopped for a license plate issue. She was determined to be intoxicated and then found to have a 0.17% blood alcohol content after being taken to the Machias Troopers Barracks for processing. She was then remanded to Cattaraugus County Jail. A 17-year-old Amherst girl was remanded to the Erie County Holding Center Wednesday after she pleaded not guilty to a criminal mischief charge in Amherst Town Court. The girl is accused of throwing a brick through the window of an Eggertsville home late on February 10th, according to police records. Sports! Have you missed Sabres hockey? I know I have. The wait is almost over. The Buffalo Sabres return to the ice Saturday against the Colorado Avalanche. 10 p.m. start. If you can't wait, the Amherst take on the Crunch tonight and tomorrow in a home-and-home. And if you prefer lacrosse, the Bandits take on the Toronto Rock Saturday at 7:30 p.m. There are now 29 restaurants nominated for the latest All Western New York Award, Western New York's Best Fish Fry. More than 100 people have offered nominations, meaning there are several duplicate nominations, which should prove interesting when voting begins on Sunday. Nominations continue until 11:59 p.m. Saturday. We found a treasure trove of live recordings Thursday night that we thought were lost forever. In all, there's more than 49 hours of live recordings, starting with All Western New York Radio's kickoff concert on April 1st, 2006. We're thinking we might start a regular radio segment with archived All Western New York Radio recordings. More on that to come. And if you like live music, check allwesternnewyorkdeals.com. We have deals to Sunday's Burtfest and Drummers Only on March 10th. See things you want, save money. Seems like a no-brainer to us. Okay, that's the news. I'm Scott Leffler for All Western New York News and Radio. Have a great day.